An SVI settling test is performed by determining the volume of 1 litre of activated sludge sample after 30 minutes of settling. Necessary equipment: 1 litre graduated cylinder, sludge sample, timer. The activated sludge sample should be collected from the feed flow into the SST. Stir the sludge sample slowly with a stirring rod. It is very important to avoid disturbance of the flocks. Gently pour the homogenized sludge into the graduated cylinder. Fill the cylinder until the total volume equals 1 liter and start the timer. Set the timer to 30 minutes. Allow the sludge to settle for 30 minutes. After 30 minutes, read the volume that is occupied by the sludge from the graduated cylinder. This is the SV30. At the end of the experiment, pour the sludge back into a 5-litre beaker. Take a sample to determine the TSS concentration of the sludge. The SVI can be calculated by dividing the SV30 by the TSS concentration. If the measured volume after 30 minutes of settling is not between 150 and 250 millilitres, it is recommended to redo the test by either diluting or concentrating the sludge until the final volume is situated between the boundaries of 150 to 250 millilitres per litre. This is then called a diluted SVI test. A batch settling curve is measured by tracking the height of the sludge blanket during settling in a graduated cylinder. Overview of equipment needed. The activated sludge sample is collected from the aeration tank. Gently homogenise the sample, avoid disturbance of the sludge as much as possible. Fill the cylindrical reservoir with the sample, pour gently in a steady flow. Start the timer immediately after filling the column. After 30 seconds, read off and record the height of the suspension liquid interface. Repeat this after 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 15, 20, 30 and 45 minutes. Recording the height of the suspension liquid interface at these time intervals results in a curve with the evolution of the sludge blanket height over time. The slope of the linear part of the batch curve is a measure of the zone settling velocity at the initial concentration x. The initial concentration x is determined by homogenizing the sludge at the end of the batch experiment and taking a sample for TSS analysis. To investigate the relation between settling velocity and sludge concentration, batch settling curves can be measured for a dilution series. A dilution series is made by diluting concentrating sludge from the return flow with effluent. Example, for a 40% dilution pour 800 millilitres of sludge into a 2-litre column and then fill the remaining space with effluent. Different concentrations will settle with a different velocity, resulting in a series of batch curves. Less concentrated samples show a faster settling behaviour. By calculating the slope for each dilution, the settling velocity in function of the sludge concentration is measured. The different settling tests require sludge samples from different locations at the treatment plant. Primary, influent, the activated sludge tank, the return sludge line, or the secondary effluent. Grab samples can be obtained with a simple sampling device, such as a bucket attached to a rope. From here, the sample is easily transferred to a container by use of a funnel. Any dilutions of samples should always be made with secondary effluent. long-distance transport of the sample should be avoided. If possible, perform the measurements on site. Long-term storage of the sample should be avoided. Perform the experiments as soon as possible after sampling. Be gentle when homogenizing your sample. Do not shake vigorously.